Back students, I hope everyone is well on your home. So the today recipe pommes duchesses. The pommes duchesses, that is one of the best recipe in the French classical menu, in which we are using a puree of tomato and mashed potato. We can add into the piping bag and bake it into the oven. So let's start. I will show you the ingredients which are required of making the pommes duchesses. So main ingredients, that is the key ingredients of potato. Fresh cream, and we need a egg yolk, not whole egg. We need a egg yolk. We can separate the egg yolk, and the rest ingredients we using butter, seasoning like salt, white pepper powder. And the most flavoring agents we can use a nutmeg powder. You can see this is a nutmeg. So guys, whenever you use a nutmeg powder, so you can use a very less amount because it is a very extremely strong flavor. So whenever you use a nutmeg powder, so you can use a very less amount. And for garnish we can use parsley. So let's start. I will show you the further process. I'll switch on the gas first. And put the saucepan into the gas. I'm going to add water for boiling of the potato. Now I'm going to add potato. We will cook the potato at least 95%. It means a full cooked potato. It will take approximately 30 to 45 minutes approximately. And the some potato is a good. So it will take 20 or 25 minutes, and the some potato, the sometime it will take timing is more than 30 to 45 minutes, because the potato we are having a different color. The golden color it will take approximately 30 minutes, and the some potato is a red color, so it will take a timing of most timing more than for the golden potato. So approximately it will take timing of 30 minutes. So let's see. And guys, now I'm going to add salt so that your potato is well cooked and fast. That's why I'm going to add salt into the potato, so it will take in less time for adding of salt. So guys, I already told you that the Duchess potato, that is a consist of the puree of mashed potato and egg yolk, butter, salt, pepper and nutmeg powder, which is force of the piping bag, or you can use a normal piping bag, you can use a paper piping bag, and you can make a virus safe, and you can bake at least a 180 degree Celsius, approximately 10 minutes. So guys, the approximate is potato is cooked. So now the timing is removing. So we can remove with the helping of perforated spoon. And keep on another bowl. So after boiling, we will peel the outer layer of the potato, and after that we will mash. So you can see the after boiling the potato. I will show you, just wait. So guys, you can see the after boiling and after peeling the potato. So Right now the timing is matching the potato. So we will mash the potato with the helping of potato masher. You can see. So guys, make sure your potato is full cooked. If your potato is not full cooked, so it will giving the taste of raw and mash properly. So now you can see the potato is a proper mash. So now the timing is adding for the rest ingredients. So now I'm going to add fresh cream. Now the timing adding for butter. Now the timing adding for salt. As per the taste you can use. Now white pepper powder, you can also use a black pepper powder. Now you can use a nutmeg powder, a little bit, not more. You can use a very less amount of nutmeg powder. And then lastly we can add egg yolk. Do not add in egg whites. So now we will separate. You can see the technique how you will remove the egg yolk into the egg. So now you can see, now I will remove the egg yolk into the egg yolk. So now we will add egg yolk. And we will mix well all mixture with the helping of spoon. Make sure your all mixture is well mixed and lumps free. If your mixture is dry, so you can also add again cream more. So that they will mixture consistency is smooth, and again mix. So now you can see guys, the mixture is ready. So now the timing is adding for this mixture into the piping bag. So I already used piping bag and put the nozzle for the star. So you can give the wire shape of the palm bucket, but I will show you the traditionally shape which are using the mostly. So now I'm going to add all mixture into the piping bag. So make sure your mixture is very smooth. If your mixture is dry, your lumps, so you do not give the perfect shape. So make sure that you mix the whole mixture and your potato should be full cooked. So now, all mixture inside of the piping bag. So now you can see. So now we will take a baking tray, that is a non-stick baking tray. Now we will grease with the helping of brush. You can use brush as well, you can also use oil, but I am using this recipe of butter. You can also use brush, guys, when you are greasing. You can use a butter frequently minor. We will brush well into frequently minor. Now I will give the shape. So right now I will sharing with the traditionally shape, which are using mostly for the palm duchess. That is a very commonly technique we can use of giving the shape of the palm duchess. So now you can see right now I will put the tray into the salamander. I already preheat the salamander 180 degrees Celsius. At least we will cook 10 minutes. So when the color is light brown, then you take out the tray and you can serve whole. And guys, you can also use a very various shape for making of the palm duchess, but the traditionally we can use in this type of shape. And we will cook at least 180 degrees Celsius for 10 minutes. So now guys, you can see the palm duchess is ready. Now remove the tray. So you can see look of the palm duchess. Hey. So So now the timing is plating. And you can also use fresh parsley as a garnish. So guys, you can see the palm duchess is ready. So I hope you will enjoy for see this recipe. So you can try also on your home. That is a very basic recipe, and this is a very basic ingredients we can use are making of the palm duchess. So thank you so much guys, I hope you will enjoy for watching this video. So thank you.